All right, we press a button, and here comes Kevin Costner and Luke Grimes, new miniseries Yellowstone. They're looking as two gents would. Kevin, you may not appreciate this, but what you have in common with our Henry DiCarlo, both proud graduates of Cal State Fullerton.
There you go.
And Orange County raised to a large degree. Kevin, you've always had this affection and appreciation for the West. Why is that?
Well, you don't have to be from it to appreciate it. I don't think anybody somehow isn't moved. You know, I mean, people see a lot of things, but sometimes when you find yourself out in the middle of Montana or anywhere, when you're staring at the Rockies, the Great Divide, you're in awe of it. It's just, and to know that it still exists, to know that it was, you know, at one point the Garden of Eden, if you will, and to then set up Yellowstone, this series against that. It's just a really added thing. I mean, we've both been a part of all kinds of different kind of programming, whether it's a courtroom dramas or blah, blah, blah. But when you find a story that can take place outdoors against that kind of background, it's special.
No question about it. Luke, Kevin tells a story very, very early at the start of his career of meeting Richard Burton on an airplane and having a conversation with Richard Burton that really altered the trajectory of his career. What about working with Kevin? Does that alter the trajectory of your career?
No.
Oh, absolutely. Come on. Don't be humble. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Kevin is a legend, and I grew up watching his films, and to be able to work alongside him now, I mean, it's an honor, and I've always said it's someone who's been working at his level for so long to still be so curious and interested and happy to be there and bring such a good energy to the work and to this project. It's something to behold, and I'm lucky to be able to be around him and watch this guy work, man.
Kevin, you've had the experience.
It's a big cast, and it's a really big cast, and Luke plays my son, and there's a lot of faces to how Yellowstone plays out. It's really good.
And I tell you what, I mean, you would be in a position to know, did you discover it was really good when you read it or as you guys were making it? Or what gave you that thought?
When I read it, I mean, there's no mystery. You know, you look at that. It doesn't mean that's the high wire you got to walk, you know, to get it to where it looks like, but when I read it, it had a lot of gold dust on it.
Yeah.
Oh, I like that phrase, gold dust. Talk to me a little bit about that, just that you had a good feeling about it.
Yeah, I mean, look, I knew going in that I was gonna read something special because it had Taylor Sheridan's name on it, and he'd been writing some things that I was a huge fan of, and so I was really looking forward to reading it. And then once I did, I knew, you know, I was going to fight tooth and nail to try to be a part of it because it's special. It's just, I really like these sort of Americana stories, and he does it better than anyone, I think.
Well, of course, we think of Hell or High Water, Sicario, certainly. Kevin, one thing I'm curious about, because Luke made reference to it, the notion of creating an appropriate vibe on the set, and I think that is always from the top of the call sheet down. Are there specific things that you try to do?
Well, you know, I think sometimes the notion of being a leading actor, maybe we got it wrong. I think, you know, sometimes maybe the lead actor could be called the best supporting actor. And what I mean by that is that some actors just come in for a day. They're nervous. They don't know what's going on. Other actors are really good, but that, you know, maybe they can get caught up in the idea that you have more experience than they do, and somehow they don't perform as well as they could because they're nervous for some whatever reason. And I think my job is to be, I think lead actors would be better off acting like supporting actors because you're the only one that can say to them, slow down, calm down, you're perfect. Say to a director, give him another take. I think that's the nature, I think, of trying to be a leading man is to, in a sense, be the best supporting guy.
That is really, really well said. And speaking of talking to directors about giving somebody another take, Kevin, you've had such great success behind the camera. Any directorial projects in your future?
Yeah, I'd like to direct a Western, a turn of the century Western where we're wearing six guns. But that's what's unique about Yellowstone. Yellowstone is going on today. There's no doubt about it. We haven't seen a series like this the way it's set, where, you know, we think we know something about that modern day ranching. But to be honest, I don't know a lot about it. I know the days start early, but this whole drama is set against that life. And I think that's what makes this really appealing.
All right, well, we'll tell you folks, Yellowstone, June 20th at 9 p.m. It's on the Paramount Network. Kevin Costner and Luke Grimes, thank you both very, very much. Nice talking to you two both. And now they're just taking it all in.
Yeah, taking you in.
No, because see they sit there. I know exactly where they are too.
Yeah.
They sit there, and then every 5 minutes, it's like, and now Dave from Wisconsin.
Right.
And
so it's got to be grueling.
Just a disembodied voice. But did you go to Cal State Fullerton in part because he went there?
Of course. Well, you know, it even goes further than that. He went to Villa Park.
I know.
Well,
that's
so
what
we
I'm
have
thinking.
The high school.
I know.
You know, I'm just waiting for a cameo. Right. Just in a cowboy.
No, but there's this great story. He was on a honeymoon in Puerto Vallarta, and on the flight home, Richard Burton had rented out all of first class.
Ooh.
And so he like left him alone. And then at the very end, he was like, you know, hey, I'm an actor too. And apparently Richard Burton said to him, I have green eyes. You have green eyes. You'll be fine.
Wow.
Well,
so there you go.
That's the problem, Sam. We don't have green eyes.
I know. That's what wrecked it.
But at least we have brown eyes.
Right.
Or at least I do.
Does he ever, he seems like one that would come
all
in.
Right,
I know we got to
show you these.
He'd come in.